beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. It is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of the Lord. Unto this holy estate, these two persons now come to be joined. Let us pray. We desire, O Lord, to acknowledge you in all our ways, that you may direct our steps. Graciously regard your servants who now come before you to assume the mutual obligations involved in marriage. And they walk not heedfully, but solemnly into this step which they are about to take. Assure them and us of your presence. Let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us in this rite we celebrate. We humbly ask in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Marriage is an institution of divine appointment. In the quietness of the Garden of Eden, before the forbidden tree yielded its fateful fruit, or the tempter had touched the world, God saw that it was not good that a man be alone. Therefore, God made a helpmate suitable for him, and established the rite of marriage, with heavenly hosts witness the wonderful event. Originated in divine wisdom and goodness, designed to promote human happiness and holiness, this rite is the foundation of the home and social order, and must remain so until the end of time. It was sanctioned and honored by the presence and power of Jesus at the marriage of Cana in Galilee, and marked the beginning of his wondrous works. It's declared by the apostles to be honorable above all. So it is ordained that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife, and these two shall be one flesh, united in hopes and aims and in sentiments and all the interests of the present time. Will you, David and Donna, have each other as your wedded to live together after God's ordinances in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love each other, comfort each other, honor, keep each other in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto your wedded as long as you both shall live? Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
I, David. Thank you, Donna.
Thank you, Donna.
For being my wedded wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for
poorer.
In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. And to you I therefore pledge,
to you I therefore pledge,
myself to you and to you only.
Myself to you and to you only.
I, Donna, take you, David. Be my wedded husband.
Be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinances.
According to God's holy ordinances.
And to you I therefore pledge.
To you I therefore pledge.
Myself to you and you only.
Myself to you and you only.
For the ceaseless reminder of this hour and the vows you've taken, place a string. With this ring, I do wed.
I do wed.
With all my worldly goods,
with all my worldly goods,
I be endowed.
I be endowed.
Do you, Donna, take this ring as a token of David's love for you, and do you wear it as a token of your love for him? With this ring, I be wed.
I be wed.
With all my worldly goods,
with all my worldly goods,
I be endowed.
I be endowed.
You, David, take this ring as a token of Donna's love for you, and do you wear it as a token of your love for her?
I do.
kind of gave me the short list that she found on some things for happiness in marriage that she asked that I read in Walking Life with Candace. It comes from the book of The Art of Marriage. The little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue for all the years. It's having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It's standing together facing the world. It's forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It's doing things for each other. Not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in a spirit of joy. It's speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's not looking for perfection in each other. It's not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have angel wings. It's cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It's having the capacity to forgive and forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It's finding room for things of the spirit. It is a common search for good and for the beautiful. Dependence is mutual and the obligation is reciprocal. And finally, it's not only marrying the right partner, but it's also being the right partner. Having pledged your faith in loving each other, having sealed your solemn marital vows by the giving and receiving the rings, now according to the ordinances of God and in the name of the state of Texas, I pronounce you husband and wife.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
I know you're married now, but
you're
that ain't gonna be not fine.
That
we
tried.
Did you see David shaking around the whole thing?
Did you see the look on his face when he saw the ring?
Yep.
It's like, what's this?
That was pretty cool.
I thought so. Okay.
I can't lose your feet. I'm going to chop them off. Perfect.
Biggest dates are 100 minutes.
Thankfully, we're in the presence of more than just us.
Take a picture just for Ryan.
Are we pictured in that?
Yeah, we don't have a picture of me and Ryan Woolby and Ryan.
Your mom, yeah, but we want to take it in here.
What'd you say?
Well, it's probably don't come out of the picture in the text.
This is delicious. These are so delicious.
Also, for you, Dan, you see our picture.
Yes. Darius. Darius. Now, I am.
Oh, man. They're going to be out in a few minutes. They're going to cut the line.